Thank you. Call it a home run in honoring Negro League Baseball. Today, the United States Post Office held unveiling ceremonies of two new stamps, which spotlight the all-black professional baseball leagues. And there was a special celebration in the town of 96. News 4's Keisha Foster was there and has more.
Yeah.
He dressed as if he had to walk the red carpet.
I got two of them, but I want you to sign.
Decked out in a white jacket and black bow tie, Robert Williams was the star of the day at the 96 post office.
Oh, man, that's wonderful. That is the most beautiful thing about it, you know what I mean? They recognized us. They didn't forget us.
I need five.
Supporters bought one or both of the 44-cent stamps.
Yeah, sign this one here.
And then lined up for Williams' autograph.
This is a very exciting day for us, historic day for us, not only for the unveiling of the stamp, but also the fact that we have an individual in our town that actually played in the old Negro Baseball League.
I thought it was a great day for all Negro League players. Just getting the recognition is something that I'm sure that they all want, and they haven't been able to get as much as, you know, as if they were playing in the major league. So it's just a great day of recognition for the Negro League players.
At the age of 21, Williams played shortstop for the Birmingham Black Barons in 1955. He only played one season because he was drafted for the U.S. Army. The Barons were a part of Negro League Baseball.
I got in the Negro League. I played with some of the best ball players and against some of the best ball players. And one thing, every team that we played, they tried to get my contract, you know. So that meant a lot to me. That made me feel like I could play ball.
Legendary stars who played in the league included Satchel Paige, Willie Mays, Hank Aaron, and Jackie Robinson. And Negro League Baseball gave black players a chance to show their talents before the major leagues were integrated. Keisha Foster, WYF News 4, live in the Anderson Newsroom.